प्लीज मैम बैठिए बोलिए संक्षिप्त में बिकॉज टाइम इज वेरी
चेयरमैन सर व्हाइल अप्रिशिएटिंग द एफर्ट्स ऑफ द गवर्नमेंट टू ब्रिंग ग्लोरी टू एंशिएंट इंडियन साइंसेस बाय क्रिएटिंग अ सेंटर ऑफ एक्सीलेंस एंड मेकिंग इट वन ऑफ नेशनल इम्पोर्टेंस अ फ्यू क्वेश्चंस राइज अप टू द माइंड पर्टिकुलरली when the objectives for the creation of this institution are analyzed. Now these objects are, number one, making this institute a model in order to demonstrate high standards of Ayurvedic medical education. Number two, preparing teachers and other personnel through training and postgraduate education. And number three, research and standardization, which I believe is the major thrust of this endeavor. When we see all these objects, one is compelled to wonder whether this mandate really requires a new institute. How is this mandate different from that of the existing antecedent institutions or existing universities? Could we have achieved the same goal by strengthening the existing institutions? Because an old house can be renovated at a much lesser cost,
right?
Ultimately making it a home than a house is more important. So the soul and the spirit, if it is there, I think the objectives can be met. I would like to mention one or two sections here. Section 6.1 provides for membership for 3 members of parliament. Sir, I would like to request you that these members be from both Treasury and opposition. Section 7.7 speaks about the term of members, which is 5 years. However, there's no clarity on the eligibility for re-election. Section 8.1 is about the nomination of the president of the institute by the central government. Why not have an election among the members for it? At the end, sir,
right,
the choice of Gujarat again has compelled many eyebrows to be raised. When several states have good institutions on Ayurveda, one fails to understand the reason for the concentration of institution in one state. For instance, the International Financial Service Center, IFFC Authority, or this particular institute.
Thank you, Farzia ji.